Greetings, fellow Earthlings. Welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are continuing with Operation Common Resolve right now. And in front of us, there are two options. One is Mission Hourglass and one is Mission Whistle Stop. Whistle Stop is about stopping a train before it heads over into the Kenyan border. Turkey? The Turkish border? Yeah, Turkish border. So... Oh wait, the train is traveling from Turkey. We need to stop before it crosses over into Georgia. Right. But this is like just a munitions train that they've hijacked. They are looking to get, better weapons. So, more power to them is essentially what we want to stop. However, Mission Hourglass, because the operation is called Common Resolve. I think operations are like how do I put this? Like the entire thing that you do to take something down. Meanwhile, a mission is just, you know, one mission. So anyway, Mission Hourglass is about finding and stopping a bomb before it explodes in a refinery near Sokhumi. So yeah, find the bomb, secure it for CDC. I just hope that it is not a time sensitive mission, because that would suck. Time sensitive missions in Delta Force suck. It's not designed for time sensitive missions, it's designed for slow and methodical approaches. So anyway, let's go and see what the mission beacon has to say about it.
Daniil must have anticipated our moves. The Scud launchers and the convoy were meant to divert attention from their primary goal. They have occupied a refinery on the outskirts of Sokhumi and have hidden a timed explosive device designed to spread the virus upon detonation. Demands have been made, and time is short. Proceed to the refinery and locate the device. Bravo will insert 800 meters southeast of the target and serve as the primary search element. Alpha and Charlie teams will move in and provide security within the refinery. Once you've located the bomb, radio King 6 for a CDC recovery team to come in for cleanup. This is a highly volatile situation. The virus is stored in protective ampoules that will allow it to spread in the event of an explosion. One stray shot could set off a lethal chain reaction. Thousands of lives are riding on this one.
Yikes. So, apparently I can't even use explosives in this level. But here's the thing, I don't know what these things are. There are like two green plus symbols here. And I think those are mostly for vehicles, but I'm not certain actually. One thing that I don't understand is why was it put here? Why do I have to like go all the way across here? Like, they could have just put me across the river and I could have just infiltrated the refinery through the river just like them. I mean, look at them inserted so close to, you know, the objective. But I need to make my way through hordes of enemies just to get to it. I'm not gonna take the shotgun attachment, though. I can't take the grenade launcher attachment. Alright, shotgun attachment is fine, have it your way. I guess I'll get to know more once I play this mission. Does not seem to be something which I need a sniper for, but
this is Black Widow. All King elements are in the LZ.
Acknowledge, break. Bravo, King 6. Find that bomb. Pick your shots carefully. This is a volatile sight.
As soon as we can start
King
getting...
King 6, Charlie 1.
Yes.
We've got a lot of movement. Looks like one and two man patrols.
This is Alpha 1.
This is Alpha 1, they're shooting civilians! Let's move!
Oh wait, did I shoot them? Were those civilians? Did I shoot them? Oh no... Oh no, did I shoot the civilians? They were civilians! Oh no... Oh no, the game didn't even warn me. Oh no. Can I redo this mission? Yeah, let's just go ahead and die and redo this mission. I was wondering why they didn't have any weapons. Oh no, I guess that's why I need military training, huh? Please shoot me. Thank you.
Well, all I guess King that elements are in the LZ.
Acknowledge, break. Bravo, King 6. Find that bomb. Pick your shots carefully. This is a volatile sight.
King 6, Charlie 1. We've got a lot of movement. Looks like one and two man patrols.
This is Alpha One. We got a bad guy to the northwest of Bravo's insertion point.
Should have gone for the first one, yeah. At least you're still waiting there, like a good little boy. Should be another person over here somewhere. Can't see him, but should be here somewhere. Oh, there he is. Thank you. Thank you for coming and thank you for dying. Alright, let's get onto the route, the main road, and let's begin eliminating hostiles one by one. I don't think this is a time-sensitive mission, because the past four times that I've tried this mission thus far, there has been no, you know, issue regarding time sensitivity, or the need to complete it within a specific time. I guess that guy's also dead. There should be another one over there somewhere. If only I can find that bugger.
Charlie team, in position.
Roger, Charlie team. You are an indispensable asset to this operation. Where is this guy? Should be three guys over here. One little spaced out, you know? Just a little spaced out. Where is this guy? Let me check on my map. He's there. Should be somewhere over here, actually. Just hidden behind this thing here. Wonder why I didn't... why I chose to just stay hidden this time around. Locate bomb and refinery. The thing is, we just need to clear the refinery of individuals first. Speaking of individuals, I won't be able to see this individual until I get over to the other side, which is a risky move. It's sort of like the computer is learning to exploit the game mechanics in its own flavor. In its own favor. Not flavor. There's another guy up on top of that, you know, mountain there. And so we need to approach it carefully. That's the refinery there. Bravo, King Six does urge Bravo to pick up the base, but I don't think there's a need to do that. It's mostly just a scripted event. Once you get close enough to the refinery, Bravo's more or less just programmed to say that anyway. I'll run until here and now I'll start walking. So the person on top of the hill does not expect me. Actually, I think approaching him from this side might be a better idea. Maybe better hide. Now, one of the issues is if you find lots of enemies shooting at you, you better get to a place where you're not that visible, because the enemies can quite literally shoot the bombs and destroy, like explode the bombs for you. So yeah, you need to be very careful about how you engage the enemies in this game. There are a few enemies inside of those buildings there. There are like a bunch of enemies over here, and one enemy that I cannot for the life of me locate, who essentially took me out in the previous round. That's why I began this this retry, this attempt, by saying, oh, that's fair, that's on me. So yeah, problem is the map that you have does not locate all the enemies that are in the area. It would help if the game lags a little less, to be honest. I have half a mind to just stop playing because of how much it lags, but I guess it's just a part of the game then. It's strange because there's only one thread online about anything concerning this lag issue, and it's basically about designing new levels for the game. And Novalogic, in all their wisdom, has actually told you to not cluster too many items close together, as that might cause lag while playing the games. And look at what they've done. Look at what they have done. The glorious mess that they have created for themselves. I'm just shooting the windows up because it's easier to see inside with the, you know, glasses blown out. There are more people on the left, we just can't see them from this angle. We have to get closer to do that. Don't think I can see any more folks from here. So here's what I'll do. I'll climb down from the back so that some random enemies can't see me and start shooting at me. And I'm gonna flank over to the other side to where Alpha Team is. It's gonna hurt. This drop right in front of me is gonna hurt. But yeah, despite the given, you know, method to play this game, despite the given viewpoint, I find this to be the better solution simply because of how accurate the enemy is with their own fire. It's like, if they decide you're gonna die, you're gonna die. There's no objection there. You simply cannot say, nah, I would rather prefer to live. No, that's not gonna happen. You are gonna die. You can see Alpha 1 and 2 there. And this is where I'll begin scouting for enemies from here. You managed to find like a couple right on this door here.
Bravo, King 6, you are running out of time!
Yeah, so when you get within a certain range of the camp, of the refinery, King 6 will tell you that you are in fact running out of time. I'm just gonna take a cursory glance to see if... Is that an enemy? Yes, that is. That's probably the one that was sniping me out every single time. The one that I could not see. Are those enemies then? No, I think they're not. They just steel structures. There are a few enemies there. We just need to approach the matter a little cautiously. And then they'll show their faces. You can find like a total of two enemies inside this building by, you know, approaching it cautiously. Or at least I did the previous time around that I played it. Craziest part about this game is, despite the zoom in function, it's incredibly difficult to see the enemies. I guess that's just a result of the low-res graphics from the era. It's zeroed in at 200, which I don't understand why it's zeroed in at 200, it just starts off like that. We'll find more in the same room, hall, whatever else you would like to call it. And that guy's also dead, and I do believe that is the last of these enemies that you'll find find this way. Because that was the case the previous time around as well. I'm just gonna keep sidestepping until the lag disappears. And then I'm gonna re-peek. Yep, somebody was shooting at us. Yep, that guy's dead. Cool. Three enemies dealt with. There was like a cool cluster in there. I wonder why. I don't know about the other huts though. And the bomb could honestly be in any one of these huts. My guess is on a hut which has enemies. That's where I put my money, but hey, you never know. You never know. I'm just waiting for the lag to go now. There is typically another guy there that I'm moving towards cautiously. Should be like three entire people over there near this truck here. But I cannot see anyone. I see one, but he's hidden behind the truck, so I'll sidestep a little. And now I'll repick. First I'll go prone because the game started lagging again. I don't know why the game lags as much. I read online that it's mostly an issue that is born out of born out of having too many items clustered together. That's two bodies there. Yeah, so apparently this lag is an issue caused by having too many items clustered together, which makes rendering difficult combined with the voxel technology that they used. But yeah, I mean, that should not really be a problem with modern systems, you know, modern graphics processing systems. And somewhere else I read an explanation that it lags when there's like, you zoomed in on particle effects, or there's like too much particle effects on the screen. Both theories are true, to be honest. I mean, whenever you're looking at some busy section of the map, the game will lag. Like this instance, for example, it's like lagging for every 5 steps that I take. And it honestly makes the game unplayable. For an FPS, I mean, reaction time is a necessity. And if you're going to take that away from a player, then what exactly does he have left with? Like, is he left with? Nothing. He's left with nothing once you take away reaction time.
Bravo, this is Alpha 2. We've got bad guys leaving the area.
Oh yeah, these guys. So we essentially shoot them, is what we do. Excuse me. Where are you? You guys need to run. Come on. You guys need to start running. Excuse me. I think I got both of them. Although I'm not certain that I was supposed to. I did not realize that getting every single person on this map was one of the objectives. And I would like to... Yes, thank you. Get rid of this guy before he escapes. And any of the other guys, if possible. Don't think I see any more people, but I would still like to be cautious. Where's the guy? Who's shooting? And from where? I would really, really like to know. Who's shooting and from where? Are they marked on the map? Of course they're not. So that's what I'm saying, like, you need to be really careful with this level. You slip up once and, well, somebody's gonna kill you. Oh wait, is that a prone guy? No, that's a dead guy. Or a prone guy. I'm guessing that's where the bomb is, because that's where all of those people started running away from. But again, of course, you can never be sure. So I'm just gonna play it a little cautious. Take a wide berth to approaching everything. Quite certain that I got all the snipers that there were. I could only see one, and I think there was only one. The game sort of goes like this. Like this level, one of the trends I've noticed is if there are going to be enemies that are also going to be exploding barrels nearby. So just so that you need to, you know, shoot carefully. This level is also so busy that I'm having to, like, essentially take two steps and just take a kneel for a bit because it's making my PC cry. Case in point. It's not even just making my PC cry, it's like a simulated lag, you know? It doesn't even feel like it's true lag. It feels like totally simulated, to be honest. I will do like a cursory sweep of the area, and hopefully all of the enemies will turn up dead. Hopefully. I see you. I see you right there. I was wondering where the third person is. There were supposed to be three people there. Well, he was laying prone on the ground. Laying prone for his life, of course. And I think that covers all the enemies on the outside, at least. Inside the homes, I'm not so certain. I'm not entirely certain about the folks inside the house. But if all the enemies have been eliminated, then we can safely begin, well, figuring out where the bomb is. Yeah, I think that's not an enemy, really. Northrop Grumman. This is also one of the visual glitches in the game, which is at least useful. It'll make all the non-game objects just disappear from the map. And the reason Alpha and Charlie team are just holding back for now is simply because I did not follow the checkpoint markers. If I had followed it, Alpha and Charlie would have been helping me with the assault. Yeah, those aren't really people. They're just support structures for the chimneys. And considering the fact that nobody's shooting at me, even though I'm standing out in the open, I'm gonna take it as a sign that, hey, this level has actually been cleared. There are no more enemies remaining. At least not on the outside anyway. Is that an enemy? It does not seem to be. What about that thing there? No, I don't think that is an enemy. Okay, Alpha and Charlie are now moving in. For whatever reason, I can hear them moving in on my Charlie team, I can hear them moving in on my right. Which is quite strange considering the fact. What the fuck are you dumbasses shooting at? And why did you cause an explosion? Can you guys hold onto your balls until this mission is over, please? I think those might just be the virus samples there. Actually, that just looks like a chair, to be honest. Might not be the virus samples. Yeah, it's just an office chair, nothing else. Alpha 2 came in here probably to... Well, that is again another office chair. A pile of barrels, good thing that it did not shoot through that window. Otherwise that would have been game over for all of us. I do not think the viruses are here. We need to figure out where the viruses are and quick. There are some more barrels here.
Ooh! Good work, Bravo! All elements, mission complete!
That was intense, to be honest. And, well, Alpha and Charlie teams are right there, converging onto destination. There was this one guy laying prone in the truck, waiting for me. Well, rather waiting for death, for I am death. Anyway, time to get off my pedestal and let's end this mission. It took a while, but I would say it was one of the more entertaining missions despite the bugs and, well, the design oversights. One of the primary design oversights being the fact that if the enemy AI tries to shoot you, it can set off bombs and detonate the entire plant. That should not be the case, but my god. So, we saved a few lives, I guess. We prevented another mobile gas tragedy. If you guys don't know what that is, Google it up. But, that was it for Operation Hourglass. We have only got one mission left here, which is Business Stop, which should ultimately unlock another mission. Antarctica was two missions, and this brings us to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8 in total, and 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 12 missions, and I think 12 or 13 is the number of total number of missions in Operation Common Resolve anyway, as far as what I read online. I don't recall right now. It's either Global Enforcement or Common Resolve, which has like 13 missions and the other has 12. I'm guessing there'll be like an additional 5th mission after Whistle Stop, so we'll get to know what it is once we address Whistle Stop, which will be the next video. As for this video, this is it for Mission Hourglass. Thank you so much for tuning in, thank you so much for watching, and thank you so much for sticking around until the end. When we come back, we will be robbing a train, black hat cowboy style, becoming a train robber in the modern day and age. Who would have thought that that would still be possible, given the speed of modern trains? Anyhow, and the security systems that they employ, but I have no idea how difficult Mission Whistle Stop is going to be. Anyway, that's like a concern for the next video. Until then, take care. Farewell, fellow Wolfgangs.